Good morning, everybody, or good afternoon, good evening. Welcome back for another intense interval training workout today. So we are mixing cardio and weights. You need one medium to heavy type of weight to lift. You are going to be lifting overhead, so make sure that it's not going to be too heavy to lift over your shoulder with one arm. So somewhere in the range of like my more advanced, like 9 to 12 to even a little bit heavier. And then you can take it easy and you can also use a lighter weight for this workout, okay? If you have a yoga mat at home, you can get that out or a large towel. And that should be all you need. All right, let's get some music on. Let's get started. Let's get warm. All right. Let's start marching. How are we today? Still missing all of you guys over at Glassport. We're hoping to get back really soon. Oh my goodness, sorry guys. All right, let's keep going. Walk it up right foot. I need more space here. This video camera is cutting off the top of my body as I walk it up. One more. V step right. My phone is choosing right now to be extremely active, so I'm going to apologize right now. I put on Do Not Disturb and it's not working. One more. Jab it right. Side kick. Walk it up left foot. Hello. How are we doing? Last one. B step left. Regular jacks are next. Then we have two touch jacks that you're gonna come down and touch the floor, and then two jab jacks. So it's down, down, out, out. Okay, that's your low impact option. Side reach jacks, just what they sound like, okay? You're gonna stick your foot out to the side, reach your arm overhead, and then the next thing is side to side. So however you wanna do that. You can do step touch, you can do one foot at a time, you can do a lateral squat, okay? A double bounce in the middle, lots of options there, okay? So that is set one. I'm gonna get my timer going. Hello, I just realized I was out of frame. A little sip of water there. Okay guys, so those walkout push-ups are first. If you wanna go to a wall for those, feel free. Otherwise you can do regular push-ups or you're gonna join me for the walkout. All right, get ready.
Get ready.
Here we go. So it's 45 seconds of work. You walk out into that plank. You do a push-up. Walk yourself up. Okay, that's one rep. It was 99 cents. So remember, if you would rather, you don't have to do the walkout. You can do wall push-ups or regular push-ups. And you're gonna make sure you're breathing. You got it. A few more seconds. Okay, guys, that's a rest. Next is jumping jacks. So here's your low impact modification. You can also do an arm out front. That's your jack without a jump, okay? 5 seconds. Ready? Here we go.
Exercise.
So if you're choosing to do the regular jack, it's right here. You can also make this a plyo, so if you want to jump, this is an option. Knowing about wearing the fur fox. I'm digging, I'm searching right through. All right, how we doing? Trash, that's another man's come up. Oh. So we're doing three rounds of each of these sets. So we're gonna kind of get most of the cardio done in this first one. Your mommy, your mammy, I'll take those flannel zebra jammies, second hand and rock that mo. So a little more segmented than we normally do. Trying to keep it fresh. 5 seconds. Oh, that Gucci, that's hella tight. I'm like, yo, that's $50 for a t-shirt. Time. Okay, guys, two touchdown jacks. So you're gonna touch the floor. Touch the floor. Jab. Jab. 4 seconds. Ready? Alright, let's do it. It's down, down, jab, jab. You got it. Good, so if you're going down to the ground, keep your chin up and your chest lifted and your eyes up. You get down by squatting, not by bending at the waist. That's how we make all the blood rush to our head. Get dizzy. Keep going. Finish it. Time. Perfect. Okay, guys, side reach jacks. No impact. Looks like this. So you're reaching overhead, tapping out that foot. Ready? All right, guys, here we go. And if you're jumping, it looks like this. Reaching that arm overhead. It's like jazzercise. Woo! Come on.
Bring the action.
When you hear this in the club, you gotta turn it down. You gotta turn it down.
Keep breathing. Do that. So remember, level one, step touch. foot hop or squat jump. All right, here we go. So I'm doing side to side squat jumps. You can also double bounce if you want to do this. It's an option. Or step touch, or a single foot hop. Good, notice I'm using these arms, getting some momentum.
Bring the action.
Keep breathing, break after this. Like. Good, so reaching overhead. Same arm, same leg moving. All right, come on. Another humid day outside. I just turned my air conditioner on early just to film this video. It was hot in here. Almost like being back at the gym, right? A little toasty. Rest. All right, guys, laterals. So side to side, any way you want to do it. Level one, with your step touch. Level two, one hop. Level three is going to be your squat jump. All right, guys, let's go. So remember, that can be a double bounce or single. Final 35 seconds, and then we get our water break. Keep breathing. Come on. You got this. Chin up. Water break. How we doing? Good deal. All right. Una mas. One more time. Same five. Here's your recovery. Starting with our walkout push-up. All kinds of jumping jacks. And finishing with our laterals. Side to side jumps. And then we will move on. So, five exercises, three sets. Next one is going to be more strength. We're going to finish up the bulk of our cardio here. That's not to say we're completely done. You guys know me better. Right? 10 seconds. Okay, guys, walkouts. So, if you want to go to the wall and do your wall push-up, get there. All right. 4 seconds. Get ready. Walkout push-ups. Let's do it. Final round for these exercises. Woo, come on. Good. Try to walk it out. Get your shoulder right over your wrist. Even though we're moving, you want to be in a good push-up position before you press. Don't forget to breathe. Come on. looping it for those of you who would like to. Let's go. You can kick up a foot too. This is gonna slow it down. We're just going full speed. Full speed ahead. Come on, let's kick our way through this cardio. And we can start lifting some heavy things. Yeah. Touches your level one. Okay, otherwise you can add in that jump. Ready. Okay, let's go, guys. So you're just moving side to side. As long as you're moving side to side, I'm happy. So you pick your level. Don't forget to breathe. Throughout. Almost. time for those overhead. So it's get the weight, press it, put it down. You're either gonna stand up or you're gonna come up, click the heels. Ready, let's go. Press it overhead, put it down, heel click. Switch hands, you're alternating arms. Good job. I know how much you guys love those heel click jump squats. Been a long time since we've done one of those. You got it, take this at your own pace. If you don't want to squat, you can also just do an overhead press here. So if you want to stay standing, almost. And time. Okay, guys, we're gonna do these hydrant kickouts. So if you have a countertop or a wall that you can hang on to, that you want to hang on to, I know I'm far away. I'm just showing you how to anchor yourself. So it's gonna be leg up and we're gonna kick it out, okay? So we're keeping our hip in, turned in, okay? And you're gonna kick, okay? I don't want you to lean too far this way. So even if you have your hand on a wall, okay? Upright, hips are square to the front. Okay, get ready. Pick up that right foot. Okay, here we go. So do your best to keep that leg up the whole time. Good, so you're just bending and extending at the knee. I didn't think this through very well. You guys keep going. I don't have anything to hang on to down here. So I'm gonna do my best to balance. I may go over to my little entertainment center in a second. Almost, keep it up. It's slow. Five, four, three, two, one. Woo! Okay, left side. So this was also kind of adapted from a kneeling fire hydrant. So if you feel more comfortable on your hands and knees, that's an option. Okay, guys, pick up that left leg. Ready? Kick it out. So my hips are staying square to the front. I am keeping my knee level with my hip as best I can. Okay, so if this is too difficult flexibility-wise, go down to the mat, okay? Go down to the floor, hands and knees. Do that side hydrant and kick your leg out. So you're just adding this kick right here, okay? Almost. See, it's better when I talk to you, right? We're already down to 10 seconds. Woo! I need a wall. I need a fake wall. Keep going. You've got this. And time. All right. Shake those legs out. Get a drink. We're repeating. You still have a little bit of time. Don't worry about those beeps. All right, guys, so same thing. Starting with our goblet squats. All right, you got about 30 seconds. How we doing? Good? Good, good. Love it. Those hips burning? They're gonna be by the end of set three. All right, you guys, you have 20 seconds, a little under. So start coming back out onto the floor, grabbing your one heavy weight. We're starting with goblets. So let's get stance. Our feet are a little more than shoulder width. Toes can be a little bit turned out. 5 seconds to go. Ready? All right, let's squat it. Push overhead. So inhale down. Exhale up. Elbows to knees. Up and squeeze. Good, good form, you guys. Keep those chests lifted. By bringing our elbows down, we are forcing our bottoms back into that proper squat position. hold your breath. Keep breathing. Almost. Time. Okay. Weight to the side. Here you have your too low, too high. Okay, another option. Low, low, high, high. Ready? Okay, let's go. Too low, too high, low, high. You got it. This is our 45 seconds of cardio for this set, so come on. Who's gearing up for those heel clicks for the next minute? Oh yeah.
We're taking that squat stance,
So our feet are a little wider than shoulder width for the goblet. Our toes are just a tad pointed out. You're under 10 seconds to start. So grab your weight, roll the shoulders down and back. Ready? All right, let's do it. Ooh, here's a good throwback tune. We're squatting Gangnam Style. Nice flashback to like, what, 5-6 years ago? Inhale down. Gosh, it was probably longer than that. Now I'm going to look it up as soon as I'm done filming. All right, guys, squeeze. Overhead. Inhale down. Exhale up. Remember, weight goes into the heels as you squat. So you're pushing out of your heels. Push yourself out of the floor. Feel those glutes kick in. Time. Okay, put your weight to the side. It's too low, too high. Ready?
Gangnam Style.
I'm literally losing it, you guys. All right, let's go. Too low, too high.
Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style.
Maybe we should just have dance party cardio. What do you think? A 1 hour dance party. That would be way more fun live, I think. We'll have to figure that one out. Almost, keep breathing. Time. Okay, guys, one heavy. You've got those squat, press overhead, heel cliff. Are we ready? 5 seconds. Remember, don't bend forward to get your weight. Bend down, okay? All right, guys, let's go. Press it overhead. Heel click. Option, remember, you're alternating an overhead press if you're not comfortable squatting and reaching to the floor.
Gangnam Style.
You got it. Keep breathing. This is our last time for this set. You guys have got this. Now we bring it down for abs. All right, put the weight to the side. You got your hydrants. So remember an option. You can come all the way down and kick out if you're more comfortable. Okay? Ready? Bring the leg up. But if you don't like going down to the floor, here's your other option. Hips are square. My chest is lifted. I should be able to lift my hand off the wall at any time. It's just there to kind of stabilize. Not leaning on it. So check yourself. Are you leaning on the wall? Your weight should be in your stable leg. And man, that hip should be kicking in. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Release. We're switching sides. All right, guys. So just turn around if you're on the wall. Remember, your hand is just there for stabilization, for balance. All right, bring it up. Kick it out. My knee is parallel to the ground. So as I kick out, my leg is parallel. Good. Inhale. Exhale. Soft knee on the stable leg. I figure we have done a lot of kneeling, like donkeys and hydrants lately. Let's try something a little different. 10 more seconds. I know you're loving me for it right now. Come on. Time. shake it out, squat it out, rub the hips, hit them, do whatever you gotta do and get a drink. And then grab your yoga mat. Alright, keep your one heavy weight close. Because y'all know I like a good weighted sit up. It's happening. It's happening. We're gonna use our weights. It's optional, you don't have to. Alright guys, get those mats out. Oh, look at that, I can get a little closer to you all today. Alright, plank jacks are first. So, options. Plank tap out. So one foot at a time. Or plank jack. Or, on the wall, tap or jump. Okay? And then we'll do our sit-ups that I have planned for you. We'll get to those. Let's just start with the planks. All right. If you're uncomfortable with the taps, then you're just going to hold the plank. How about that? One more option. You know we like our options. All right, guys. Plank jacks or plank tap outs. Y'all ready? Go. So you can do one foot or both. You can be on the wall right now standing. You can do one foot standing or 2 feet. Good. Get your shoulders over your wrist. Come on. 20 seconds. Keep going. Back flat, bottom down. Keep breathing. Time. Okay, guys, come on down onto your bottoms. We're going to do an L sit-up, so grab your heavy. Feet are out in front of you straight. You've got one weight or no weight. Ready? You're going to sit up, press the weight overhead. Ideally, I would like you to cup both heads of your weight. We've been over this before. My power block weights do not allow me to do that. So that's why I'm holding the middle. I'm afraid that my hands would slip off the plates. And I don't really feel like getting a concussion today. So you guys can see, you can do this without a weight. Just sit up nice and tall. Make that L with your body. Feet are flexed, they're together. Time. Okay, next thing. You're gonna take your weight, reach for your toes. Alright? Again, you do not have to have a weight for this. You can do it without a weight. Ready? Alright, guys, let's go. So you sit up, you reach for your toes. You reach overhead. Toes. Overhead. Okay, so we're still pulling that weight down. There you go. You got it. So every time you sit up, see if you can reach just that teeny weeny bit further to the toes. Relax. All right, what do we got? Ooh, side V ups. All right, come on your right side. 1 foot or two coming up. So level one, you can have the bottom foot bent, 1 foot up. Level two, both legs. Come on. So my elbow's under my shoulder. My rib cage is lifted. I am gonna roll back just a tiny bit onto my glute instead of being straight on my hip for this one. So my feet are on a slight angle. They are not straight out from my body. I'd say like not quite a 45 degree angle, a little less. Good, so remember you can do top leg only. Five, All right, guys, reset. Shoulder right over the elbow. Feet are at an angle. They are flexed. Roll back onto that glute. Lift them up. You can do this. And there's no stopping. We're going to switch up some of the abs for next set, okay? So if you hated one of these, I'm going to switch it up just a little bit. These V-ups anyway. Your water break. Grab a sip of water if you need it. We're going to start over again with our plank jacks. Yes. Okay. And I'm actually going to use my two mediums instead of my one heavy. I don't like the grip I was getting off that weight, so grab those. Safety first, right? Always safety first. So make sure that you feel safe with the exercises that we're doing, guys, okay? All right, let's bring it back out and get started. So if you're on the wall doing your plank jacks, go ahead and head back over. Otherwise, you're not on the mat with me. Everybody good and rested? You got your water? Okay, ready? Get yourself set in that plank position and go. Plank jacks. Or 1 foot at a time, that's up to you. So you can make it a tap or a jack. Just keep moving. Shoulder over wrist, bottom down. Good, keep your head in line with your spine. So don't look down, don't look up. Keep going. Reach. franchise is still effective without a weight. And if your weight's very heavy, you might not want it for this. So the choice is yours. You got it. Almost. Time. Okay, you guys, switch hands. If you need to roll that shoulder up, go ahead and do that. Left hand to right toe this time, okay? So you can see my feet are wide, they are flexed. I'm gonna come back with this weight behind me, ready? And then I'm gonna sit up and reach. Overhead, sit up and reach. So, to star sit up. So this time, instead of those outside obliques, we're working these transverse abdominals, so crossing the plane in front. That's what tightens your whole belly. Keep going, you've got it. Down. All right, you guys, since we're down here, take an arm, bring it across. Let's stretch those shoulders. Switch. All right, rock it on up, grab a drink. We have one more set. Plank jacks are first. Make sure your weights are out of the way. Plank jacks, wall or floor. You guys ready? Let's come on back to the center. Get in your plank position. And begin. Final round. Remember, you can tap out 1 foot at a time. Bottom down, belly button tight. Take it to that L sit up. Weights are optional.
Exercise.
All right, here we go. My feet are out. They're flexed. I'm going to sit up and I'm going to press my weight overhead. I'm inhaling on the way down. I'm exhaling as I sit up. Like to go to the wall. Final exercise. We're any left. If you want to, you can start pressing toes, heels. You want to rock back and forth. You got this. You're doing awesome today. Time. Knees down, child's pose. You guys are awesome. Let's stretch. Another one in the books. All right, guys, let's come up onto all fours. Shoulder over wrist and elbow. Inhale, arch the back down, lift the head. Shoulders stay away from the ears. Exhale, round. Good, inhale, arch. Head up. And exhale, round. Good, let's come back to that neutral spine. Take that right arm up, needle it through. All right, guys, let's carefully take that arm back out. And we're gonna switch sides, left arm up, needle it through. Great job today, you guys. Some wardrobe malfunctions over here. Okay, when you're ready, let's take that arm back out, coming back to our center position. All right, let's go ahead and just come right down onto our backs. So swing around, come on onto your mat, bring the knees into your chest, rock. Okay, keep your right leg in. Rotate, wiggle. Switch direction. Point flex. Extend. Okay, cross it over the other knee. Left leg in tabletop, pull it in. Stretch that glute. It should feel real good. All right, let's release. We're going to switch sides. Left knee in, rotate and wiggle. Switch it. Point flex. Extend. All right, take that left leg, cross it over the right. Right leg comes in a tabletop and we pull it in. Let's release. Let's take the soles of our feet together. So we're pushing our knees out wide to the side. This is going to open up your hip flexors. Did you already forget about all those fun standing hydrant kicks we did? I bet your hips didn't. Feel better? I hope so. Okay. Go ahead, relax. Release the feet, grab on one leg, rock yourself up to a seated position. Two breaths with me. Inhale, exhale, one more breath. Inhale, exhale. Yay! Virtual high fives, you guys are done. You did awesome today. Thanks for joining me as always, and I will see you next time. Bye.